Yay!
Turn to number 400 in the blue hymnal. Let's sing praises to our God. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Blessed be his kingdom, now and forever. Amen.
Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Page 356, the Gloria, together.
Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks,
We praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Almighty God, the fountain of all wisdom, you know our necessities before we ask and our ignorance in asking. Have compassion on our weakness and mercifully give us those things for which our unworthiness we dare not and for our blindness cannot ask, through the worthiness of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Please be seated and attentive to the reading of God's word.
Our first lesson comes from the first book of the Bible, Genesis chapter 28, verses 10 through 19a. The reading can be found in your online bulletin or your personal Bibles and on page 22 of your pew Bible. A reading from Genesis. Jacob left Beersheba and went toward Haran. He came to a certain place and stayed there for the night, because the sun had set. Taking one of the stones of the place, he put it under his head and lay down in that place. And he dreamed that there was a ladder set up on the earth, the top of it reaching to heaven, and the angels of God were ascending and descending on it. And the Lord stood beside him and said, I am the Lord, the God of Abraham, your father, and the God of Isaac. The land on which you lie I will give to you and to your offspring. And your offspring shall be like the dust of the earth, and you shall spread abroad to the west and to the east and to the north and to the south. And all the families of the earth shall be blessed in you and in your offspring. Know that I am with you and will keep you whenever you go, wherever you go, and will bring you back to this land. For I will not leave you until I have done what I have promised you. Then Jacob woke from this sleep and said, surely the Lord is in this place, and I did not know it. And he was afraid and said, how awesome is this place? This is none other than the house of God, and this is the gate of heaven. So Jacob rose early in the morning, and he took the stone that he had put under his head and set it up for a pillar and poured oil on top of it. He called that place Bethel, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The psalm appointed for today is Psalm 139, verses 1 through 11, and 22 and 23. Psalm is found in your online bulletin and on page 794 in the Book of Common Prayer. Let us pray Psalm 139, verses 1 through 11, 22 and 23, responsively by whole verse. I will begin. Lord, you have searched me out and known me. You know my sitting down and my rising up. You discern my thoughts from afar.
You trace my journeys and my resting places, and are acquainted with all my ways.
Indeed, there is not a word on my lips but you, O Lord, know it all together.
You press upon me behind and before, and lay your hand upon me.
Such knowledge is too wonderful for me. It is so high that I cannot attain to it.
Where can I go from your spirit? Where can I flee from your presence?
If I climb up to heaven, you are there. If I make the grave my bed, you are there also.
If I take the wings of the morning and dwell in the uttermost parts of the sea,
even there your hand will lead me, and your right hand hold me fast.
If I say, surely the darkness will cover me, and the light around me turns to night.
Darkness is not dark to you. The night is as bright as the day. Darkness and light to you are both alike.
Search me, O God, and know my heart. Try me and know my restless thoughts.
Look well whether there be any wickedness in me, and lead me in the way that is everlasting. Our second lesson comes from Paul's letter to the church in Rome, chapter 8, verses 12 through 25. The reading can be found in your online bulletin, your personal Bibles, and page 919 of your pew Bible. A reading from Romans. So then, brothers and sisters, there are no debtors, not to the flesh, to live according to the flesh. For if you live according to the flesh, you will die. But if by the Spirit you put to death the deeds of the body, you will live. For all who are led by the Spirit of God are children of God. For you did not receive a spirit of slavery to fall back into fear, but you received a spirit of adoption. When we cry, Abba, Father, it is that very Spirit bearing witness with our spirit that we are children of God. And if children, then heirs, heirs of God and joint heirs with Christ, if in fact we suffer with him, so that we may also be glorified with him. I consider that the sufferings of this present time are not worth comparing with the glory about to be revealed to us. For the creation waits with eager longing for the revealing of the children of God. For the creation was subjected to futility, not of its own will, but by the will of the one who subjected it, in hope that the creation itself will be set free from its bondage to decay and will obtain the freedom of the glory of the children of God. We know that the whole creation has been groaning in labor pains until now, and not only the creation, but we ourselves. We have the first fruits of the Spirit, grown inwardly while we wait for adoption, the redemption of our bodies. For in hope we are saved. Now hope that is seen is not hope, for who hopes for what is seen? But if we hope for what we do not see, we wait for it with patience. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
Another parable Jesus put before the crowds. The kingdom of heaven may be compared to one who sowed good seed in his field. But while everyone was asleep, an enemy came and sowed weeds among the wheat and then went away. So when the plants came up and bore grain, then the weeds appeared as well. The slaves of the householder came to him and said, Master, did you not sow good seed in your field? Where then did these weeds come from? He answered, An enemy has done this. And the slaves said to him, Then do you want us to go and gather them? But he replied, No, for in gathering the weeds, you would uproot the wheat as well. Let both of them grow together until the harvest. And at the harvest time, I will tell the reapers, Collect the weeds first and bind them in bundles to be burned, but gather the weeds into my barn. Then he left the crowds and went into the house. The disciples approached him, saying, "Explain to us the parable of the weeds of the field." He answered, "The one who sows the good seed is the Son of Man. The field is the world, and the good seeds are the children of the kingdom. The weeds are the children of the evil one, and the enemy who sowed them is the devil. The harvest is the end of the age, and the reapers are the angels. Just as the weeds are collected and burned up with fire, so will it be at the end of the age. The Son of Man will send his angels, and they will collect out of his kingdom all causes of sin and evil and all evildoers, and they will be thrown into the fire of furnace of fire, where there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. Then the righteous will shine like the sun in the kingdom of their Father. Let anyone with ears listen." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Please pray with and for me. In words of my mouth and the meditation of all our hearts, be acceptable to you, our Savior and Redeemer. Brother God, may only your words be spoken and your words heard. This we pray in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please be seated. On more than one occasion, I have been accused of being a Baptist preacher in an Episcopal dress. And if that were the case, if I were indeed a Baptist preacher in an Episcopal dress, this would be our gospel lesson, just prime for preaching brimstone and hellfire. This would be one of them sermons where we could be talking about sin and the consequences of sin. But I'm not. I'm an Episcopalian, so I can't preach about that. But what I can preach about today is dreams. Before I got into ministry, before Jane and I retired from ballooning, it was our job to promote for the companies that hired us using a hot air balloon, and we would go on tour promoting these hot air balloon promotions. We would leave home at the end of Easter, about a week or two after Easter, and then we would not get back home until about a week before Thanksgiving. We were on the road the entire time. Not unlike Jacob in our Old Testament story, we knew what we were supposed to do. We were out doing these great promotions. But unlike Jacob, we knew that we were going to have to find some place to sleep. Now, when Jacob was out traveling, and back in the day, you could go from point A to point B, and it was not uncommon when night fell fall that you would find a nice tree and a nice brook or a nice quiet place, and you'd take out your knapsack and you would unroll it and you would lay down wherever you were to sleep. Well, it got to be kind of a game with Jane and I that we would take a look at our atlas, and we had on our laptop a program called Street Atlas. Y'all remember Street Atlas, right? And Street Atlas was cutting edge at the time, and we could figure out where we would end up, and then we would look up hotels. Now, we would look up the hotels, and Jane likes adventure. And I'd be looking for all of the Holiday Inns and the Motel Sixes and the Radissons and those kinds of places. But my beloved bride would try to find the funkiest mom and pop shop ever. She was looking for those places with the big wagon wheels out front, or big windmills out front, or maybe a bear out front. And those would be the places Jane, who was driving, would say, "This is where we're going to spend the night." And my dutiful response was, yes, dear, okay. And so we would pull in and we would check in. And, you know, after a quick looking around to make sure that we weren't going to get eaten in the middle of the night, we would check in. And most of the hotels would provide you with a very firm mattress, right? Because firm mattresses will hold up over a longer period of time, and a really thin pillow, because they were inexpensive at the time, which was fine with me because I liked a firm mattress and a thin pillow. But from time to time, even we were surprised at the level of comfort which we found in some of these hotels. Jacob, in his travels, would roll out his mat, and he would be sleeping on the floor, or sleeping on the ground. And if we got any outdoor campers in the congregation, people who have spent more than one night in a tent, right, with a really thin mattress pad that absolutely let you know where every pebble and rock were, right? That would have been his world. That would have been Jacob's world, not the world that Jane and I enjoy so much. And when you're sleeping in those kinds of conditions, the brain has a tendency to wander. The brain has a tendency to do its own thing. When you dream under those kinds of circumstances, that your imagination runs wild. When Jane and I would travel a lot, if we had a bad dream, we could often pinpoint it to the little funky diner that we ate at the night before, or the hotel that we were in. Very seldom were they visions given to us from God. Well, Jacob, sleeping on the ground, had a vision of God, and his vision was a ladder that was coming up and down, and he saw angels coming up and down on it. I would like to think that part of Jacob's problem was that he used a stone for a pillow. Once you get your head wrapped around the idea that, first of all, you're on the ground, you have a really thin mattress pad, and you've looked around and you have found the most comfortable rock to put underneath your head to sleep on. If that's not the things that were going to give you nightmares, I don't know what would. But this ladder that was given to him in this vision, with angels coming up and down, shows the connection that God has with his people. Commentators would tell us that the word ladder is actually a translation for what is a highway, a stairway between here and heaven. Jacob saw the first stairway to heaven. Think about that one for a second. Well, if there's a stairway to heaven, that's an indication to us that God actually does want to have a relationship, that he is actually present and here and connecting with all of us in this stairway up and down. And he saw angels coming down delivering things, and he saw angels going up taking things away from him. That lets me know that we are indeed surrounded by angels, and that God has made sure that we can do, with the help that he is giving us, what he has asked us to do. I've had an occasion where I've had a dream or two which has been prophetic, but more often than not, they are just the imaginations of my mind running wild. But this vision of Jacob was one to help him realize that he did have work to do, and that God was going to be following him all along the path. Would it be that our dreams today would give us the reassurance that God is with us? Most of my dreams are playing the what-if game. What if I won that lottery? Right? What if I were on my cross-country adventure and doing my own thing? How wonderful would it be that God would speak to us in such a dream and give us a vision of what heaven would be like and the assurance that he is with us all the time, right here and right now. The vision that we have should be representative of what we ought to be doing all day long, which is praising God. And I would pray that as we lay our heads down tonight on our soft beds and our pillows, that God would touch us and inspire us and encourage us to do what we know that we need to be doing, lest we end up with the vision of the parable that Jesus gives us. Let us be that good seed that has been sown, raising up and producing a harvest that is 100-fold or 60-fold or 30-fold, which is what we heard in our last week's lesson. May the Lord grant us all each tonight a good night's sleep, and may we be thankful that we're not sleeping on the ground. May we be thankful that we're not sleeping with rocks under our heads, or maybe we should do that. Get out of our comfortable beds and get out on the streets and get out in the fields and sleep, and thereby open us up to what the Lord would be saying to us. And whatever it is that he's saying, let us follow, listen, and obey. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Turning to page 358 in the Book of Common Prayer, page 358. Let us stand and affirm what we know to be true is written for us in the ancient words of the Nicene Creed. When I ask you, my brothers and sisters, what do you believe? Together,
we believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate of the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Kneeling, let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor.
prayers of the people for the season of Pentecost are Form 5 and start on page 389 of the Book of Common Prayer. In peace, let us pray to the Lord, saying, Lord, have mercy. For the Holy Church of God, that it may be filled with truth and love, and be found without fault all the day of your coming, we pray to you, O Lord, saying,
Lord, have mercy.
For Michael, our presiding bishop, Michael Hun, our bishop, Daniel and Scott, our priest, and for all bishops and other ministers, and for all thy the holy people of God, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For all who fear God and believe in you, Lord Christ, that our divisions may cease and that all may be one as you and the Father are one, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the mission of the church, that in faithful witness it may preach the gospel to the ends of the earth. Today we pray especially for St. Paul's in Truth and for Consequences and Christ Church in Hillsboro. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For those who do not yet believe, and for those who have lost their faith, that they may receive the light of the gospel, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of the world, that a spirit of respect and forbearance may grow among nations and peoples, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For those in positions of public trust, especially Joe, our president, and Michelle and Greg, our governors, that they may serve justice and promote the dignity and freedom of every person, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For all who live and work in this community, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For a blessing upon all human labor, and for the right use of the riches of creation, that the world may be freed from poverty, famine, and disaster, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the poor, the persecuted, the sick, and all who suffer, for refugees, prisoners, and all who are in danger, that they may be relieved and protected. Today, we pray especially for Jim, Ray, Mike, Alan, Lee, Keith, Brandy, Bertha, Patsy, Becky, Jeanette, Yvette, Anna, Jessica P., Nita, John, Marianne, Alfonso, Jenny B., Angelica, and Mando. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this congregation, that we may be delivered from hardness of heart, and show forth your glory in all that we do, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our enemies and those who wish us harm, and for all whom we have injured or offended, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For all who have commended themselves to our prayers, for our families, friends, and neighbors, that being freed from anxiety, they may live in joy, peace, and health, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For all who have died in the communion of your church, we pray for the repose of the soul for Frederick Andrew Gerber, Thomas Powers, Laura West, Jane Lamb, James David Glass, and Dr. Evan Davies, and those whose faith is known to you alone, that with all the saints they may have rest in that place where there is no pain or grief, but life eternal. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Please add your own intercessions and thanksgiving at this time, either silently or aloud.
Pray for those who are being adversely affected by the heat wave across this nation.
rejoicing in the fellowship of St. Luke and all the saints, let us commend ourselves and one another and all our life to Christ our Lord.
To you, O Lord, our God. O Lord, our God, accept the fervent prayers of your people. In the multitude of your mercies, look with compassion upon us and all who turn to you for help. For you are gracious, O lover of souls, and to you we give glory, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen. Let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor. Let's spend a moment or two in personal reflection of our lives and confession to our Lord before we continue with our public corporate confession. On page 360, together, most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us our
that we may delight
in our world and walk in your ways to the glory of your name. Amen.
Almighty God, have mercy on you. Forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ. Strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life.
Amen.
Please stand. Dear brothers and sisters, the peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Please share that peace with those closest to you.
Peace. Peace.
Everybody have a seat. Sit. Everybody's got a bulletin. Take it out, open it up, look at it, read it, mark it, inwardly digest it so I don't have to remind you of it. It's hot outside, and because it's hot outside, you know that refreshments are necessary. So we have, and we're going to provide for everybody who's here today, sorry folks out there in Facebook land, we got a snow cone machine. We got two snow cone machines, and we have a variety of snow cone flavors, some of them aimed particularly at grown-up kids.
But no alcohol.
But no alcohol. They're alcohol free. But they're going to be lovely, and they are going to be cold, and they will be extremely refreshing. So after service, if you're out and you want to come back in and try them, that's fine. We're going to have snow cones, something to help cool us off on a very hot day. I think it's going to be a lot of fun. Birthdays and anniversaries. We got anybody celebrating anything fancy this week? No? Any other announcements for the good of the congregation? Lorenzo's gone, so he can't correct me. Jane, anything you can think of? are, yes, still collecting briskets for our country fair. We're still collecting clothes for the barn. Walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself for us, an offering and sacrifice to God.
Thank you. hands of praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. For you are the source of light and life. You made us in your image and called us to new life in Jesus Christ our Lord. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Together,
holy, 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 holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You may kneel or remain standing. We give thanks to you, O God, for the goodness and love which you have made known to us in creation, in the calling of Israel to be your people, in your word spoken through the prophets, and above all in the word made flesh, Jesus, your Son. For in these last days you sent him to be incarnate from the Virgin Mary, to be the Savior and Redeemer of the world. In him you have delivered us from evil and made us worthy to stand before you. In him you have brought us out of error into truth, out of sin into righteousness, out of death into life. On the night before he died for us, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread, and when he had given thanks to you, he broke it, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, according to his command, O Father, together we remember his death. We proclaim his resurrection. We await his coming in glory. We offer our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving to you, O Lord of all, presenting to you from your creation this bread, this wine. We pray you, gracious God, to send your Holy Spirit upon these gifts, that they may be the sacrament of the body of Christ, his blood of the new covenant. Unite us to your Son in his sacrifice, that we may be acceptable through him, being sanctified by the Holy Spirit. In the fullness of time, put all things in subjection under your Christ, and bring us to that heavenly country where, with Saint Luke and all of your saints, we may enter the everlasting heritage of your sons and daughters, through Jesus Christ our Lord, the firstborn of all creation, the head of the church, and the author of our salvation. By him, and with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever.
Amen.
And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to pray, "Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen."
God for the people of God, take him remembering that Jesus Christ died for you, and feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving. The table of our Lord Jesus Christ has been set. He is our host, we are his guest. This table is open to any who are hungry. All who are thirsty are welcome to come to this God's table. Page 366. Page 366 in the Book of Common Prayer. Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, we thank you for feeding us with the spiritual food of the most precious body and blood of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and for assuring us in these holy mysteries that we are living members of the body of your Son. Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face towards you and give you peace. And the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be upon you this day and always. Amen. Please stand for our processional hymn.
Thanks be to God. Hallelujah.